for the person, God will always be personal. For the person, everything is personified. Do you ever see anything which cannot be touched, which is not bodily? Name anything which you cannot see, touch, smell, think of, conceptualize, imagine, put in your pocket, point at, name anything. Whenever the person will try to talk of God, he will always attribute a name, a figure, a form to the truth. That is his helplessness. What else can he do? Being what he is, what else would he do? He will say, God is beautiful. Now, what does beautiful mean? Beautiful as the rose. So he has brought down God to the level of the rose. Now the rose will wither away. God would also wither away. Now the rose is very beautiful to somebody and not as beautiful to the other one. So the perception of God too must be subjective then. Do not talk of God as a person. As a person, talk only of the person and see what it means to live as a person. What does it mean to live as a person? Meaning, what does it mean to... What's your name?
Hiral.
Hiral. What does it mean to live as Hiral? You know what Hiral is? Hiral is the name given to him by somebody. And hence the expectations, obligations attached with it. And hence the whole burden of knowledge. And hence a pre-decided future. That is what the person is. The person must limit himself to the person. Because that is his proper domain. If he will try to go beyond, he will only get more of the person, but name it as God. And that is blasphemy. That is not quite right. God is neither personal nor impersonal. God is not. There is nothing called God. God is not a thing. God is nothing that you can think of. So don't even talk about God. That is the best and the highest respect you can pay to God. Do not even talk of Him. By talking of Him, you malign Him. By building a church for Him, you bring Him down to your own dimension. By praising Him, you lace Him with attributes that are suitable only to humans. But that is the kind of treatment we have been giving truth. And that explains the kind of treatment we have been giving to ourselves. That explains why we suffer. Because we talk so much about God. Leave God alone. Don't touch that purity with your dirty hands.
Isn't that another conditioning, like in a way, to say that God is so pure that as men we are like a lower...
Well said, well said. Whenever we will talk, we will run into these contradictions. So do not even say that God is very pure. Just say that I feel that I am not quite pure. And full stop. No need to talk about God. Because whenever you will say God is pure, you will have some image of purity. Again, you are doing the unthinkable. Again, you are doing what you must not do. God is not even pure. God is not even superior. God is not great at all. Because if God is great, then Alexander was also great. And you have brought down God to the level of Alexander. If God is greatest, it is still a comparative statement. Greatest to whom? Compared to whom? So you are still comparing God to something. And if you are comparing something to something else, they both must be in the same dimension. So you can't even say God is greatest. Just hold yourself from thinking of God. Think rather of your own situation and think deeply. Deeply. That is real religiosity. Do not remember God. Do not remember God because you cannot remember God. You will remember something else, thinking that it is God.